Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss how to do the isometric view of a given circular lamina. Here the given question is, draw the isometric view of a circular lamina of diameter 50 mm on all the three principal planes using four center method. Here we are taking the circular plane. Circular plane is, I am taking this as an example, it has width and it has height, it has no thickness. If you see here, it is looking like a line, it has negligible thickness. Okay, this is a 2D diagram, only two dimensions it has, width and height, okay, x value and y value, z value is 0, that is thickness is 0. Now we can call this is a orthographic view or two dimensional view, okay. So for this orthographic view or two dimensional diagram, we have to do the isometric view. Isometric view means it is a three dimensional diagram. We have to convert this orthographic view, that is two dimensional diagram, into three dimensional diagram. For converting the 2D diagram into 3D diagram, that is isometric diagram, we have two methods. One is called four center method. The another method is coordinate method. The coordinate method, already we did the video. I will give the video link in description box. Please check it. Three principal planes we are taking for doing the isometric view. Let us do the isometric view by using the four center method. Initially, for any isometric view, we have to do the orthographic diagram. Orthographic diagram is given circular plane. For plane, we can call it as lamina also. Okay. Let us do the circle here. Okay. What is the diameter of it? It is 50 mm. Take the radius is 2.5 cm. By using compass, I am taking the radius is 2.5 cm. Okay, let us do one circle here. Take any one of the point as center. Take this is the center. Here do the horizontal diameter. Again do the vertical diameter. For doing the vertical diameter, I am taking, as we know, vertical line is perpendicular to horizontal line. This angle is 90 degrees. And at this point, this scale should coincide with this line. Here, I am using set squares for getting the line. Extend this line. It is a vertical diameter. Okay, after getting horizontal diameter, vertical diameter, here for any diagram, for doing the isometric view, do the box which is passing through all these endpoints. Okay, so let us take this is a reference line. Here do one line. Here also do one line. Similarly, take this is a reference line. At this point, do line. Similarly, here also do one line. Now we kept this circle in a box. What type of box it is? It is a square, because this is the diameter of this circle, this length, and this length is diameter of the circle. Both are same here. So it is a square. Give the names for the box corners. So give here in orthographic view small letters P, Q, R, S. Okay, for the middle point, this is the middle point for this line. Okay, now here this is give small a, small b, small c, small d. Okay, this is a two dimensional diagram, that is orthographic view. For this, we have to convert into isometric view. In it also, we have two methods. First method, in first method, we are taking the initial point, that is P point. In isometric view, we are taking the capital letters. Take the P point at any place here. I am taking this is a P point. So in isometric views, we are taking the capital letters. After doing the P point, here do the small horizontal line. Take this line is a reference line, okay, here, and move the scale up to P. Here do one line, small line, okay, and then here take one inclined line which is making 30. This side also one 30 degrees line. In the protractor, take 30 degrees this side and take 30 degrees this side, okay. Join these points to P. Okay, so at one side of P, mark this horizontal length, PQ length, by using compass, mark on this inclined line. This is a Q point, mark this point is Q point. The other side of P, mark this vertical length. Okay, as we know, this length and this length are same because it is a square. Okay, take this length by using compass. So P as center, do a knot here. The intersection point is S. At S, do the SR line. This SR line is parallel to PQ. Okay, here we will get SR line parallel to this line. For getting the parallel line, I am using roller scale. keep the scale here, move the scale up to S and do the line. Okay. Similarly, at Q, do the QR line. This line is parallel to PS. So QR line is parallel to PS. Keep the scale here, move the scale. Okay, this intersection point is R point. Here in the orthographic view, we have one square. It is looking like rhombus in the isometric view. After that, mark these midpoints. Okay, by using compass, take this VA length, mark on PQ. So this is a middle point A. These are all middle points. Okay, whatever length here, take the same length this side. On PS, middle point is D. Take the same length, S as center, do an arc. This point is C point, B point on QR. Q as center, mark B. So we got all the middle points. In this first method, we did the rhombus like this, roughly I did here. These are the middle points. Okay. SQ, one diagonal, and RP, one diagonal. Which is the shorter one? So shortest is here PR. Okay, take always shorter diagonal, two ends, opposite ends. Okay, these two are the centers. Okay, and here take one of the center, join this center to, join this point to the opposite middle points. So for R, opposite middle points are A and D. Okay, join R to D and R to A, like this. Okay, join these middle points to the opposite end, it is R. And join R to A. Similarly, take the another end of the shorter diagonal. Join this end to opposite middle points. BC are the opposite middle points. Join to P, join to C. Similarly, join these middle points to P. Okay, these two are the centers, remember always. And these intersection points are also the centers. E and F. So how many centers? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 centers. Taking this point is E point. This point is F point. Here listen carefully. We are using 4 centers. So by using 4 centers, we are doing the ellipse here. Okay. So why we are doing ellipse means circle is looking like ellipse in the isometric view. Okay. What are the 4 centers means? P is one center. Okay. And next center is R. And the next center is E. And next center is F. These are the centers. P as center, we will get this radius. This is the another arc. If you are taking P center, radius is PC. P center, PC radius. Here, do an arc here. Okay, here for getting the arc, always take the arc like this. Because R is the center, as I told. So arc is coming with this radius. Here one arc will come, roughly I am doing here, and then next center is R center. Okay, what is the radius? RD or RA radius. Okay, here I am taking RD radius, R center, RA or RD radius. Okay, do an arc here, and E center, this is the radius, we will get another arc like this. And next E center, EC or ED radius. EC radius, center EC radius, do an arc here. Okay, we will get the arc here. F center, we will get this radius and we will get the ellipse like this. Okay, 4 centers. And next center is F center, FA or FB radius, FA center, FA radius, do an arc here. Okay, after this first method, take the second method. In second method, vertical lines are coming as it is. Whatever vertical lines are there, those are coming as it is. Okay. Take any vertical line is the reference line. Here at some place, do the vertical line. Okay, on it, take this PS length by using compass. Take any one of the point is P point here, capital letter. From P, do an arc on this line. So this point is capital S point. Here we did PS length on the vertical line. And now after that, take this horizontal line in the form of inclined line. Okay, here all horizontal lines are tilting 30 degrees in isometric view. Take this horizontal line, it is tilting 30 degrees. Now join this P point to 30 degrees line. On it, mark this length, PQ length. By using compass, take this length, mark here. This is the Q point. At Q, do the vertical line. As I told, in the second method, we are taking all vertical lines as it is. Okay. Now take, this is the reference line. Move the scale at Q, do the vertical line. Mark this QR length here on this vertical line. Take this intersection point is capital R, join S and R. This line is parallel to this line. In this rhombus, mark these points, middle points. Okay, take this length and this length and this length, all are same. Okay, because these are the middle points of the square sides. Now take this point, it is the capital A. Next, D point here. This is the capital D. This point is C point, this B point at Q. After getting the middle points in this rhombus, take the shorter diagonal. As we know, it has PR diagonal and QS diagonal. Take the shorter one. QS is the shorter diagonal compared to this one. Okay, take Q point, join this Q to opposite middle points. These two are the opposite middle points to Q. Join this Q to C and D. Similarly, in the shorter diagonal, take this side, join S point to opposite middle points. What are the opposite middle points? AB. Join AB to S. Now take the intersection points here. This is E, this is F. Okay. Here, always remember, shorter side diagonal, two ends are two centers. Okay. This is Q is a center, QD radius, we will get one arc here. Similarly, S is another center, we will get another arc here. Okay, so shorter diagonal opposite sides, Q and S, two centers. Okay, and next center is E and F. Now these are the centers, and what is the radius if Q is center? Q is center means we can take this radius or this radius. QC radius I will write here, QC radius, Q as center, QC. Radius, okay, just do an arc like this. Okay, and next center is S center. What is the radius? Here we will get one arc, SA radius or SB radius. Okay, I will write here SA radius. Do an arc here, A and B, okay, like this. And next center is E center. Here EA radius or ED radius. Okay, here we will get one arc, EA radius. So E center, EA radius, one arc here like this. And next center is F center, FB radius or FC radius. So F center, FB radius, do an arc here. This is the second method, possible case of doing the isometric view with initial point P. We have another method also in the second one. Instead of taking P point of this box, we are taking Q point initially. Okay, we are doing the vertical lines as it is in this method also. Take initially Q point. Take, this is a reference line. Move the scale. And here after some gap, do one vertical line. So on this vertical line, mark QR length by using compass. Mark this length. This point is Q point. And this point is R point. So vertical line is coming as it is, and here horizontal lines are tilting 30 degrees. So at Q take 30 degrees line. Mark 30 here. Take 30 here and join to this Q point. Do one line here. This line is tilting 30 degrees. Okay. Now on this inclined line, take this QP length. Here mark from Q. Okay, this length is, this point is P point. At P again do the vertical line of this length. for doing the vertical line, take this is the reference line, any vertical line at P, do the vertical line of some length. On it mark this PS length. Do an arc, extend this line up to this arc. So this intersection point is S point. So here also we got rhombus with Q is the initial point. Now in this rhombus mark the middle points. Okay, these are the A, B, C, D. Okay, take this length, okay, and this length, both are same. Here from P as center, do an arc. This is the A point. P as center, mark this middle point. This point is D point. Okay, this point. And similarly, this length same. So S as center, do an arc here. This is C point. And Q as center, do an arc. This is the P point. Okay, here we have marked all the middle points. So in this rhombus, which is a shorter diagonal? By seeing this, we can tell QS is a longer diagonal and PR is a shorter diagonal. Okay, now take these two are the centers. Whatever shorter diagonal endpoints are there, take those two are the centers. Take initially P point, join this P point to opposite middle points. What are the opposite middle points to P? B and C. Join PC and PB. And PC. Similarly, take the opposite end to P. Join this R to opposite middle points. A and D are the opposite to R. Join R to these two points. Take these intersection points. This point is E, this point is F. Okay. Now here what are the centers? As we are taking opposite shorter ends, these two ends are the centers and EF are the centers. These shorter ends are the two centers. If you are taking P center, what is the radius? This PB or PC is the radius, like this. Okay, we'll get one arc. So PB is the radius. P is the center, PB is the radius, do an arc here. And next center is opposite to P, it is R center. What is the radius? RD or RA. Okay. So R center, RA radius, do an arc here. Okay. Now next center is E center. What is the radius? EA or EB. Okay. EA will write here. E center, EA radius, do an arc here. Okay. Next F center, FC or FD radius. F center, FC radius, do an arc here. So this is the isometric view for this orthographic view. Here we did the two methods for doing the isometric views. In the first method, so both horizontal line, vertical lines are tilting 30 degrees to the horizontal plane, horizontal line. Okay, and then here in next method, all vertical lines are as it is. Okay, in both cases. And here horizontal lines are tilting 30 degrees to the horizontal line. Okay, here in this first case, we are taking initial point is P. In next case, we are taking the initial point Q. Okay. In these two methods, we are using the four center method for doing the isometric view. Okay. In the isometric view, circle is looking like ellipse. Okay. In all the four center methods, here after getting this rhombus box, always take shorter diagonal length. Here in this diagonal, here in this rhombus, shorter diagonal is RP or PR compared to SQ. Okay. That's why they take these two are the centers initially. Here the shorter diagonal is QS, okay, compared to PR. That's why take shorter diagonal ends are centers. Here which is the shorter diagonal? PR is the shorter diagonal compared to the other one. Take these two are the centers. Okay, like that you have to remember for getting the four center method. So it is easy and accurate way of getting the isometric view. And mark the given dimensions here. Take any one of the side, take diameter is 50. Here also the dimensional line is parallel to this main line. Here also dimensional line is parallel to this line. Here in all these diagrams, the ellipse should be in dark color compared to this rhombus. Okay, here also rhombus is in light color.